Hi all, welcome back to our channel Sankalp to explore India. Are you planning to stay at Nandi Hills? Watch the complete video for details. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Let's have a look at channel intro. Nandi Hills is an ancient hill fortress built by Ganga dynasty and later enlarged and strengthened by Tipu Sultan in southern India in the Chikkabalapur district of Karnataka state. It is 10 kilometers from Chikkabalapur town and approximately 60 kilometers from Bengaluru. Roads are very good and you will enjoy the drive between hills. Take a look at the state, Gandhi Nilaya, where we are planning to stay today. Here we are at Gandhi Nilaya. This is the old block of Gandhi Nilaya and left side we have new block. We have reception located in old block. Old block has only two rooms, deluxe and suite room. Once you enter the building on left you have suite room and on the right side it is deluxe room. Let's take a look at deluxe room. Room is good but it lacks a private balcony. If you don't have option and booked this room, at reception you can take help for accessing a balcony outside. Now let's take a look at suite room. This room ideally suits for a family. Suite room has two twin bed setup and it can accommodate 4 people. Both rooms comes with cupboard and all basic amenities. Guess what? Suite room has a big private balcony. View from balcony is really breathtaking. Toilets are clean and well maintained. You can see the complete view of old block behind us. Now we are moving towards the new block where we have booked our room. You can make booking from popular websites Make My Trip, GoIBibo, Booking, and you can search for hotel as Hotel Mayura Pine Top. You will see a clear differentiation in old block and new block when booking rooms. Let's take a look at our room. All rooms in new block has a balcony facing sun rays point. You need not to go to any crowded viewpoint to enjoy the sun rays. You can enjoy from your room balcony. There is only one restaurant at Nandi Hills, but food is not that tasty. Now, let's take a look of sun rays at Nandi Hills. The view is magnificent, isn't it? There are many viewpoints to enjoy the sun rays, but make sure you reach early. Vehicles can be parked on the side of the road near Gandhi Nilaya. This is the place called Tipu Drop, from where Tipu Sultan used to drop traitors and British sympathizers. There are many stories about the origin of the name Nandi Hills. During the Chola period, Nandi Hills was called Ananda Giri, meaning the hill of happiness. It is also perhaps called Nandi Hills because the hills resemble a sleeping bull. Another theory holds that the hill gets its name from an ancient 1300-year-old Dravidian-style Nandi in temple situated on this hill. Here we are at Yoga Nandishwara Temple, a Hindu temple situated at top of Nandi Hills or Nandi Durg. This is a dedicated to the Lord Shiva and it dates back to the Cholas period. Lush green parks and the weather of Nandi Hills will create a pleasant mood and is the only hill station very near to Bengaluru. This is Nehru Nilaya and this is the place where the first ever SAARC summit hosted by India was held at Nandi Hills in 1986. Guess what? You can book room here as well and enjoy British architecture. But sadly, we couldn't find proper information to book this. I will share the booking details once I have the complete information. Bhoga Nandishwara Temple is a Hindu temple located in Nandi village at the base of Nandi Hills. It is dedicated to the Hindu god Shiva. The original temple in the complex, identified as one of the oldest temples of Karnataka, dates back to the early 9th century. The earliest inscriptions referring to the construction of the temple for Shiva, according to the Archaeological Survey of India, are from Nolamba dynasty ruler Nolambadiraja and the Rashtrakuta Emperor Govinda III dated year 806 and copper plates of the Banna rulers Jayateja and Dattya of about 810. The temple was later under the patronage of successive notable South Indian dynasties, the Ganga dynasty, the Chola Empire, the Hosla Empire and the Vijayanagara Empire. In the post-medieval era, the local chiefs of Chikballapura and the rulers of the Mysore kingdom controlled the region before it eventually came under British rule after the death of Tipu Sultan in year 1799. The architectural style is Dravidian. Photography and videography is strictly prohibited inside temple. Thank you for watching. For any further information, you can leave comments. I will respond to you at the earliest. Do not forget to subscribe to channel and leave your valuable comments. Signing off, Sankalp.